excitement, and I'm making this video in my bedroom trying to get away from the family because they're so noisy. You can't do a video with screaming kids and barking dog and whatever. So once again, techbait.net, my news aggregator site, brings me this article. Buying Bitcoin is not investing, claims Oracle of Omaha Warren Buffett. Now, this isn't the first time old Warren has shut his mouth off about Bitcoin. So here he goes again. This is the same guy who says he doesn't really know what Bitcoin is, and he even says it here. No one knows exactly what Bitcoin is. No, people do know what Bitcoin is, Mr. Buffett. You don't know what it is, and most of your finance guys don't know what it is, and you old guys don't know what it is, but there are people who knows what it is because it's real and it was created. It's software, you know? I mean, it's as real as your copy of Microsoft Windows or Apple, you know, Mac OS or whatever. I mean, it's software. You know, it runs on computers. I mean, it's virtual in the fact, you know, you can't hold it, you know, just like you can't hold a copy of Windows. You can only hold the computer it runs on. Well, it's the same thing with Bitcoin, you know. I mean, you can't hold it in your hand, but it doesn't mean that it doesn't have value. It doesn't mean that it doesn't have economic value. I mean, you know, entire companies, billion-dollar fortunes were built on top of software. And this guy sits here and acts like, you know, this thing doesn't have any value because he doesn't personally, he can't quantify it, you know. I mean, it's absurd. Enough with this garbage already. Enough with these dinosaurs who don't understand it. They shouldn't be writing, you know, dictating how people think about this. You know, step aside. I mean, he's 87 years old, for crying out loud. I mean, was the guy got another year or two left, tops? I mean, unless he lives well into his 90s, but still, you know. I'm not wishing anything bad on the guy, but, I mean, come on already. It's ridiculous. So, you know, here is his quote. This is an interesting quote. Now, listen to this. If you buy something like a farm, an apartment house, an interest in a business, you can do that on a private basis, and it's a perfectly satisfactory investment. You look at the investment itself to deliver the return to you. Now, if you buy something like Bitcoin or some cryptocurrency, you don't really have anything that has produced anything. You're just hoping the next guy pays more. Well, you know, what about Forex trading? What about currency trading in general, which has been going on a long time? And what about commodity trading? I mean, yeah, okay, you could make the argument, yeah, that gold and precious metals have a certain intrinsic value. But once again, that's only the value that people agree that it has. I mean, you know, I mean, gold, even though you can make jewelry out of it, it's still people like it and they're willing to spend money on it in order to wear it. I guess it has certain industrial uses. I know silver has many more industrial uses. And I know platinum and things like that have industrial uses, right? But, you know, it's still, you know, those more so, they have real industrial uses. Gold is usually the big one. But get back to, like, currency trading. I mean, what is the dollar, the euro, the pound, whatever? All these things are fiat currencies. I mean, they're not. And even when they were backed by something, what were they backed by? Gold or silver? You know, gold again? So, and once again, it's because people, it's a pretty shiny metal. I mean, through the ages, what made gold valuable? It was pretty, it was shiny, and it was limited in quantity. I mean, you couldn't just pull it out of your ass, right? So, you know, Bitcoin has that scarcity. You can only produce so many Bitcoin. Now, people like to argue that and say, well, you've got all these other altcoins, you've got a million different altcoins, so therefore it's not scarce. Well, they're not Bitcoin, okay? They're not Bitcoin. There's copies of Bitcoin. They have certain similar utility, but they're not Bitcoin. And Bitcoin's the big one, right? And a lot of these other ones are going to go bye-bye eventually, but Bitcoin will still be there, most likely. And Bitcoin is being, you know, in the investing world in general, they're starting to accept that it's like digital gold or it's got other, and not to mention to create a Bitcoin, you've got the proof of work thing. You know, you got the proof of work thing. It takes a certain amount of electricity and computing power to like produce a Bitcoin. So this whole idea that it's absolutely nothing is actually, the nothing is the argument that it's nothing. Okay. So, you know, I mean, yeah, if we have a certain kind of a war like a nuclear war. But, you know, there's a lot of things that aren't going to be worth anything if that happens, much less Bitcoin. I mean, at that point, even your gold isn't going to help you. You know, you're going to need guns and ammo if you're even a survivor. Even medicine won't help you in that case. So I don't know what the whole idea here is that, you know, dumping on Bitcoin. It's you know, but you know, the reporters, they want that. They ask these guys their opinion, so they're going to give it. So then it's going to get broadcast out there. It's going to get used as FUD, you know, for whatever reason, either to keep the price down so a lot of people who are fighting it actually really are buying it. Just like, you know, J.P. Morgan, you know, Jamie Dimon was bad-mouthing it, you know, and then they went in and bought. So, yeah, so there you go. Ousted CEO of PayPal. Yeah, like should we really care what this guy, or the 94-year-old Charlie Munger said that Bitcoin is simply disgusting. You know, these guys, you know, it's almost laughable, but these people are powerful people in our system. And a lot of people respect their opinion, so it is dangerous, and it does need to be countered. It needs to be countered, and people need to be educated as to the various values of all these blockchains. I mean, let's not even get into Ethereum and dApps and smart contracts on how those things and a lot of these other altcoin ecosystems are going to change the world. They're going to change business, all right? Don't tell me there's no value in that, because there's a lot of value in it. And, you know, Bitcoin was the first one. All right, the first real working one, and it is very valuable. So I hate to break it to old Warren that it's valuable, that it is valuable, even though he thinks it isn't. So there you go, more FUD by Warren Buffett and the media that likes to pull this stuff out of him. Fight it every chance you get, and understand that he's wrong. I don't care how rich he is, he's wrong. All right, see you next time. Thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, hit the notifications. We'd appreciate it very much. Thank you.